here at Kell that were Little Longhorns at one point. So they know what it's like. They know what it's like to be given to, and so now they're giving back, and we really want our entire student body to experience that. Giving back, that's what the Christmas spirit, the holiday spirit is about, is truly giving back. And when you see the smiles on these kids' faces, when they get to buy pretty much whatever they want. They go to Walmart, they're given an amount of money, they get to buy whatever they want. And most of them want to buy for their family. They don't want to buy for themselves. And so this is the time that we can say, no, this is about you. You get to enjoy it. You get to have the holiday that you deserve. So we want to make that possible for all of these kids. We're at about 80 teams right now. We need at least 20 more. Please think about donating not only your time, your money. Really, really makes it worth it for these kids.
Lives are changed.
Yes.
Indeed.
Thanks, Eric. Now, Mia, do you want to know what I think?
What?
I think it's gotten a little too quiet in here. Let's see if Marshall can liven it up again.
Definitely. And remember, Longhorns, there's still plenty of time to donate. So let's get those slips in.
Can't wait for the next one. Mia, I feel like it's time for something.
I think you're right, Bryn. It's time to check out the donation board. Drum roll, please.
All right, we're up to $83.97. That's definitely an improvement from our last check. But we know we can do a lot better, right, Kel?
Right.
See, even the crew is excited, so come on, Kel, get excited to donate, and teachers, please keep sending your runners to the AV studio.
So, Mia, you know what always puts me in the holiday spirit? Singing to some classic holiday tunes, and I know plenty of students at Kel agree, so let's see if some Kel students can finish the lyrics.
Hey, guys, today we're playing Finish the Lyrics. Let's go.
Frosty the Snowman
was a very happy soul.
With a corn cob pipe and a button nose.
And two eyes made out of coal.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring.
Snowing and blowing our bushels up fine.
Now the jingle hop has begun.
I don't want a lot for Christmas.
There is just one thing I need.
Don't care about the presents
underneath the Christmas tree. I really can't stay.
But baby, it's cold outside.
Got to go away.
But baby, it is cold outside.
This evening has been.
Been hoping that you drop in.
Santa baby.
Slip a sable under the tree. For me.
Been an awful good girl.
Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight.
Dashing through the snow.
In a one-horse open sleigh.
Through the fields we go. Laughing all the way.
Ha ha ha.
Elle was so talented. It may have been a little off-key, but hey, at least they're getting the holiday spirit.
Speaking of off-key, we have another sing-along. We hope you all enjoy.
Oh, holy night, stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pine, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angels' voices. Oh, die, divine. Christ was born, and I, divine, oh, now, oh, my divine.
Wow, just wow. Eli Huey wanted to let everybody know that he is available for birthday parties, weddings, and other events. But let's get back to business.
Let's. There is still plenty of time to donate Longhorns, so just scrounge up anything that you can afford to give and place them in the baggie so we can make this Shop with a Longhorn better than before.
Preach it, Bryn, but I'll be honest. I'm a little embarrassed about something.
What, Mia? You can tell me.
Well, Shop with the Longhorn is about making sure people can buy presents for their loved ones.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, not all of us know what to do with those presents after we buy them.
What do you mean?
I don't know how to wrap a present, Bryn.
Oh, well, Kylie has a wonderful, informative video on how to show you how to wrap a present. Let's watch. Santa Claus is
Hey guys, so the first step to wrapping a present is just go ahead and lay out that wrapping paper, put your present right where you want it on that wrapping paper, go ahead and fold one side of the paper down onto your present, and you're going to want to go ahead and tape that just to make sure it stays on your present. Go ahead and flip that wrapping paper right over and measure where you want to cut to make sure it covers your present, and after this, just go ahead and cut it. Then I'm taking my wrapping paper, folding the edges down, and I like to put scissors right on top so that the paper doesn't get crazy while I get tape out, and I just go ahead and tape that. three pieces usually works for me. Then go ahead and cut off not all of the paper on the side, but the majority of the paper. Go ahead and put that aside as well, because we're going to be using this later when we add a little extra something to the present. So once you've cut that extra off, just go ahead, fold those corners in there, and fold the top up. Again, I like to just fold it down to make it look nice and seamless. And just go ahead and do the same exact steps and repeat this to the other side. So now you have a super cute wrapped present. The next thing we're going to be doing is making a pinwheel bow to go on top of it. You're going to take one of your access pieces of paper and cut it into about a rectangle. Then you're going to cut down each of the four corners, so you have four pieces, cutting about midway so they all still connect in the middle. Alright, so the next thing we're going to do is tape down the left side of each piece of the papers. So you should have four left side corners taped down when you're all finished with this part. Okay, so the next thing you're going to want to go ahead and do is just grab a little piece of tape and tape your cute bow wherever you want on the present. I just put mine on the corner, but you can put yours wherever. Next, I'm adding a little bunch of ribbon that I just put together, and I taped that to the corner. I think it's so cute, and it kind of hides the middle, gives it a little extra touch. Of course, you could just also put a little mini bow right in the middle as well if you didn't want to bunch together some ribbon. The last step I'm doing is cutting a little extra piece of wrapping paper to make a cute little card on the present. So if you don't have any Christmas tags or stickers, you could just make it with a little extra piece of the wrapping paper and then just go ahead and stick that right on. All right, guys, so now you have a super cute wrapped Christmas present. I hope you guys liked this how-to video, and happy holidays.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah, I don't think you were making a big deal out of nothing. Well, anyway, I think Eric has a very special guest here to talk to us about Shop the Longhorn. Eric, who are you with now?
Ho, ho, ho! What's up, Eric?
What's up?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Here's a candy cane. Merry Christmas. How are
you
today?
Merry Christmas. Amazing. How are you?
My hat's in the way. Well, I'll tell you what. The elves are on strike, man. So we need help from Shop With A Longhorn this year. As you can see, I'm covered in fairy dust. I filled up my sleigh with fairy dust. So we need help with Shop With A Longhorn this year.
Yeah, yes, we do.
It's been a rough year for Santa this year, I'm going to tell you. Because the elves went on strike recently. They don't want to get paid in peppermint patties and pixie sticks anymore. They want cash. They want $15 an hour minimum wage. That's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Santa can't do that. Santa's ain't got the funds for that. So trying to get them a little more pixie sticks, a little more candy, but it's not working out. So right now they're on strike. So we need your help with Shop With A Longhorn to get more toys out there, more money for these youngsters here. I don't know what to tell you. Mrs. Claus and I went out for a walk the other day. Those stinking elves have put deer meat in my shoes. We got attacked by a polar bear. Mrs. Claus is still in the hospital, but that's okay. So we just need help. We need you guys to give. We need to get more teams going together. I know some of our sports teams don't have teams yet, like lacrosse maybe. Maybe lacrosse needs to get some more teams. We need more people donating money. What else do you have to say? I can keep going.
You know, Shop With A Longhorn, it's such a big thing, maybe even bigger than Santa, honestly.
It's bigger than Santa, for sure.
Yeah. What kind of effect do you think that has on our community?
Well, I think it does. I mean, we've been doing it for a long time here, and every year, like last year, a youngster came in with no shoes on, and we got him shoes, and Santa was crying during that. So, it's a great time, and you see kids, you know, over the years, you see siblings, you see other kids, you see friends, family, so it's just a great time. And I know the players and the athletes and the students that take the kids to Walmart always have a great time, and they come back and everybody's happy. Nobody's throwing stuff at Santa, nobody's crying on Santa's lap. Once in a while they take a number one on Santa's lap, but other than that, it's okay. So, you know, we just have a great time, and I'm looking forward to it this year.
And what were the dates that the students could join the Shop with a Longhorn?
I think we cut off is tomorrow, but I think they'll keep taking people afterwards. I think because it's the following, it's the week we come back after vacation. It's that following Saturday, December 7th, Pearl Harbor Day. So, but I know tomorrow is supposed to be the cutoff day, but you know, you never know. We need everybody here we get, so we're not going to tell people now. Yes. Let's see what else we have. Well, I have presents for everybody here. Let's see. I know what you like. I got you something special, man. A box of Fruity Pebbles for you, my friend.
Oh, my favorite.
Let's see what else I got here. Got you some Peeps, my friend. There you go. Got some snowman Peeps for you on the guitar over there. There you go. Happy birthday. Merry Christmas. You guys over there got a little... Who else am I going off the stage here? Got a Rudolph Red-Nosed Reindeer for you guys. Nice. There we go. Got a Star Wars coloring book for you. There you go. Nice. I got bubbles for the whole group here. We can do bubbles later.
Sweet.
I was flying by Korea, and I got some seaweed. You guys can have seaweed, cameraman. There you go. Nice. I got the reindeers wouldn't ride me, so I had to drive down here, so I got some carrots. We can have them later or whatever. But got a lot of stuff in here. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at the elves have been at it again. Look what they put in my bag. I hate those elves. They put steaks in my bag. What is that about? Come on, man. Lord. I got a bunch of candy canes. There's more candy canes for everybody.
Hey, this is what the Christmas spirit
is
all
about. It is. It's about giving. Giving, you know?
And you think that just pork reinforces with the kids who do this? The kids want to do this for in the future?
Yeah, I think it's for the fun. I think, you know, you start out as a freshman, you do it every year, and you get to know the kids. You get to know working with the kids, riding in the bus, being nice on the bus, not throwing stuff out the bus windows when you're going to Walmart. Being nice in Walmart, staying with your children, not taking off and going to the candy aisle and stuff like that. It's just a great time.
It's a great, you great know. Time.
We have face painting in the morning, and then we get the kids get Chick-fil-A biscuits, and then they get on the bus and they come back. And
it's amazing where we can give back to our community in everything.
In every way.
In every single way.
Everything
awesome.
You want. More seaweed, whatever you want to do, yeah.
Seaweed, bubbles,
so,
it's great.
It's awesome. I love being here. I love doing it. And I come down here specifically from North Pole for the Shop with a Longhorn thing just because I've been doing it for a long time. I know it's a special time of year and all the kids have a good time. You know, when I see kids later on at Christmas, you know, some of the kids wait up for me when I come out of the chimney and I have to throw fairy dust on them and knock them out. But, you know, they see me and they remember me, so it's good. You know, it's just, I just can't trust the elves anymore.
Yeah, okay. Can't trust them.
Can't trust them
at all.
We still have more time. We could do a little game here if you want.
Sure, let's play a game.
I can find his markers here. There we go. Let's play Guess the Teacher. This is an old one Santa's done in the past. Let's see. Okay. I'm going to draw some. You tell me who it is. And I'll add to it. Who's that right there? We can't tell, right?
Circle.
Could be
circle
anybody,
person.
Right? Let's say it's... Who's that now?
Levine!
Mr. Levine!
That's you! Yeah!
We got that one. Santa's got to get new suit. Let's try this again. Let's see. Let's try this again. Who's that? I don't know. Let's
another circle person.
Let's do it this time. Let's go. The man with no neck. Who's it now?
Mr.
Honeycutt!
Oh, that's not. Oh,
dad,
no.
Okay, maybe not. Okay, I'll see. We're done with that one. Okay. I could go farther now. That's okay.
You have any more games, Santa?
Let's see. I don't know. I can talk more about the elves, how much I hate the elves. The things they were doing. The wife of Mrs. Claus and I went windsurfing the other day. Evidently, the elves had greased the bottom of our windsurfing boards with elf grease, so the orcas attacked us, so... Mrs. Claus is still getting over that, too. They took a chomp out of my windboard. The killer whales came over and attacked us. That was nice.
I thought everybody loved Santa.
Well, you know, when you're a predator of the sea, the giant, most massive predator in the sea, as the orcas are, you know, sometimes they lose a little bit of that view. Aquaman wasn't there to save me, so it's just Sometimes what happens, I don't know, man.
Yeah.
Let's break out those pebbles, homie.
You want to break out these pretty pebbles?
Break out those pretty pebbles.
Right, do you have any milk with this?
No, Santa eats them dry. Oh, and I got some maple syrup, too. Here you go. Some maple syrup. Santa stopped at Cracker Barrel on the way, too. I love the Uncle Herschel's breakfast meal. It's great, because I get the catfish. We don't get a lot of catfish if we're on cold, so. It's awesome with the potato casserole.
That's right.
That's good stuff, isn't it?
This is right. Take the whole thing.
Let's go. What? That's good. Really good. Oh, yeah. Santa can talk now. It is good.
I need some more.
Go for it. You're right. We could use some milk in my beard and my mouth now. Yeah. So we want to ask everybody, get your groups together, whether you're on a team, a club, you know, just kids in school. We need you to sign up for Shop with a Longhorn and get in a group, okay? Because we can't do this without you, whatever camera we're on, because I don't even know.
We need you for Shop with a Longhorn.
We need you with Shop with a Longhorn. Ho, ho, ho. And whatever you do for Christmas, do not watch the little drummer boy to make Santa cry every time. I'm good with Santa Claus just coming to town, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, a year without Santa Claus, but little drummer boy.
Or that last holiday movie with Queen Latifah.
I draw a line there, man. I'm sorry.
You watch that one?
I watch, what's that one with the elves that I hate the elves now? The
Elf.
Prep and Landing. I like that one.
What's the one with Will Ferrell? Elf?
That one's Elf's a good one too, yeah.
Yeah.
My son, Elf, that's true. That is a great movie, though. That's true.
That's awesome. You know how he puts like the maple syrup in the spaghetti?
Everything.
All the candy, yep.
What is the slogan in that movie? When we sing?
You're a cotton-headed ninny muggins.
No, they sing something. It's something
like that was his insult.
I don't know. Let's sing a song together. Let's go. Let's sing, what song should we sing? Santa Claus is coming to town?
Yeah.
You better watch out. You better not cry. Better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you wish. Checking it twice. Know the words or don't sing. He's naughty or nice.
Santa Claus is coming.
Coming to town. If you sing like that, you're going to get pork and beans in your stocking. So you don't do that. If you sing good, you get bubbles, okay?
Yes.
We could do some bubbles, man.
Or more fruity pebbles.
Or more fruity pebbles. They're down Santa's sleeves now, too, so I'm covered in fruity pebbles and elf dust. So.
You want to do the bubbles?
You can do the bubbles here. Go ahead. You're a big boy now.
Okay. Yeah, you're right.
But please, guys, come out for Shop with a Longhorn. Be there with us. Santa's falling apart. But it's only 2 weeks away. It doesn't seem like it's 2 weeks away, does it?
No, it really doesn't.
It doesn't seem like Christmas away.
It really doesn't.
My elves are on strike. You're struggling with that. Use the microphone and punch a hole in it.
Yeah.
Right through the bottom. There you go.
Yeah.
Nice.
All right.
So I'm going to court next week with the elves to get them off strike so we can get our toys ready to go and get the sleigh ready because without the elves, I'm up a tree. So there we go. That is Christmas spirit right
these
there.
These smell good.
They do? What do they smell like?
I don't
afraid
know.
To ask.
Like,
we have any one of those psychedelic videos like you were just showing with that Santa song? That was
amazing bubbles.
That was messed up, man. Well, look at that. Look at the sky.
You want to try?
Sure, Santa will try. It'll be in my beard, but it doesn't matter.
It's cool. Yeah, it's cool, you know.
Make sure you're doing something for Shop with a Longhorn, guys. You're volunteering or just... Oh, Santa can't breathe. There we go. Ooh, these smell weird, dude. And they taste weird, too.
Yeah.
That's why I got them Santa got those at the dollar store. That was a mistake, but...
Yeah. But so, Shop with a Longhorn, it's just... Do it. It's amazing.
It is. It makes you feel good. And it makes Santa's Christmas every year when I'm driving.
It melts your heart. It really
2 million
does.
Miles a year. What is all of
yeah.
The bubbles?
All right. Well, everybody have an amazing holiday. Yep.
Okay.
Shop with the Longhorn.
Merry Christmas.
Yes.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
I hate happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
It's great.
Have a great Christmas, guys.
Thank you, Santa, for our gifts.
Thanks, guys. Eric. I honestly didn't think he was real, but now I know.
Mia, you didn't think he was real?
No, not really.
I've always believed, but I'm surprised it didn't mention, you know.
What?
You know.
What?
You know.
What?
I don't want to say, but here's a small video about it.
Detective Snow.
And Detective Frost.
And we're the ones who are going to find Santa for you kids.
I'm
No way.
When should we go?
Right now. I was not expecting the North Pole to be this warm.
I know, it's like mildly fresh out here.
Yeah. You know,
it's a little bit humid, but it's pretty good.
And there's trees, it's green.
Yeah, dude, I know.
How are we gonna find Santa, though?
Before... Oh! No way. Oh!
What do y'all want? I'm old.
Dude, you literally missed Christmas. What happened?
Twice
a year, bro. Like,
dude. When you get my age, look, the good looks, magic, bro. But when you get my age, you don't know what to do. It's a whole lot of whatever y'all kids say.
But we need you. There's chaos out there.
Dude, the kids are going nuts, bro, because you're not here.
Their parents get them gifts. Like, let them...
They believe in you. Like, what's up with that? Like,
can you come back? Please?
Dude.
Where are my reindeer at? Look at me, I'm looking in the woods.
We can help you with that. But just come back, please. It's okay.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
That's so sad.
I told you I didn't want to say it. Anyway, on a higher note, we've raised $237.09 for Shop with a Longhorn. We're only $2,200 away from our goal. Let's see what other holiday enjoyment we can bring to the masses.
Well, I sure do like Christmas trees, especially decorating them.
Have you ever seen a Charlie tree?
I've never heard of a Charlie Brown Christmas tree.
They're a very rare sort of coniferous fern, only found in Nova Scotia.
You don't say?
Yep. But Cal students Riley and Madison got one specially delivered for us, and they filmed themselves decorating it. Check it out.
Guys, we're decorating a Christmas tree.
I think one of your ornaments shot her.
Hey,
Well, now I know what a Charlie tree is. Brian, are you listening to me?
What?
Were you paying attention?
No, sorry. I'm playing this new Call of Duty mod. It has snowballs. You want to see?
I mean, I guess, if it's more important than me.
Let's check it out.
All right, boys, join up. I got the custom game lobby in. Let's go. All right, is everyone in?
Yeah. Wait, dude.
Where's William? Oh my God, dude. You literally been in the bathroom for like 30 minutes. Come on, hurry up.
Bro.
I gotta go to bed soon, dude.
Bro, y'all literally about to get smacked.
Yeah, dude. I brought up the dark matter, bro.
We have a new set. Good. Look at your hat. I bet you spent like 200 bucks on
wearing the defaults, you know?
You spent $20 for what?
I got this for this.
Dude,
I'm gonna get mine.
We can't hear you, William.
Bro! I was talking the whole time.
Oh my goodness.
Every single time.
Repeat what you said. No, heard it.
Alright, boys. We're ready. This is the time, alright? First round, easy. Okay, let's just take them out one by one. Stick together.
Straight strap.
Push A, push B, push A. Dude, come on, you got this, it's almost over, man. Get up, please.
Go without me.
Please. No, bro, I can't.
Go
no.
Without me.
Oh, my. Bomb planted.
Trapped him for like 50 headshot points. Oh my God, dude, this is awesome. I'm just gonna stay here for the rest of the round.
Just do it.
You're 0-10, but you'll be okay.
Come on.
Just win it. Come on. 3v1. Show us that you're actually good at this game. Yes, William. Yes, William.
Good jump shot. Good jump shot.
He's lagging.
He's lagging.
Yes, my God.
He's lagging.
William.
Okay, I can see what all the rage is about. But let's not forget why we're here today.
Shop with a Longhorn?
Yep. Let's check in with the classes and see what's up.
Well, that wouldn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Thank you. get any computer, I need it.
Kidding myself, darling. It's hopeless, really. It's pathetic, I suppose.
It is, yeah. Hello, who's this?
Merry Christmas, Melvin.
It can't be.
Look at you, darling. I think I already have. Get it?
Hey,
Miss
Kirk.
How
much
has
your
class
donated
today?
We have a grand total of zero, but we are just getting started.
That
is
super cool.
Bruh.
Wait. We're going to interview you. Is that okay? What
are
your
holiday
tradition? I
think
that's
awesome.
All right. This
is
finished
the
lyric. I'm so cold. I'm
is
finished
the
lyric. I'm icy. I'm clean. I'm so cold. I'm
icy.
Okay.
All right, so we're just going to – most classrooms are actually testing right now. First period is apparently a big testing period, so we're just going to find random people in the hallway, ask about the traditions. You know, this guy right here.
Right here.
What's going on, man? What
– traditions
– do
you
have?
Traditions?
For, like, the holidays.
Oh, go to my family, house, eat, get gifts, eat, hang out, have fun.
Cool, that's awesome. All right, thank you.
We saw you dancing, so we're here to ask you – what's your favorite Christmas dance?
My Christmas dance?
Like the dab or stuff like that. Well-known Christmas dances.
I don't know. It's too early for Christmas.
It's never too early for Christmas.
Good job, Longhorns.
Welcome back, Longhorns. Do you know what I love?
What do you love, Mia?
Holiday movies like Home Alone, Christmas Vacation, Die Hard, and Miracle on 34th Street.
Me too. The Grinch and Rudolph, too.
You want to know what I heard, though?
What?
They're rebooting both of those.
What?
Yeah, Kell's own Lorenzo Mora is rebooting both of those classics for Hollywood.
Are there trailers?
Yep. Roll it.
Please. I promise I'm good enough. I'll do anything.
I'm sorry, child.
Dang it, Santa. If only I was good enough.
In due time, you will be ready.
What if I was a human? Cupid, Donner, and Blitz.
But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Charles.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer game. In one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came.
Yo, Santa, I'm a human now.
What are you gonna do now that you're human?
I never thought about this. What am I gonna do?
To all my haters, unless you're the hardest reindeer, turn human, you might as well keep your trap shut.
Need to pick it up, Grinch. One elf can do.
Man, everything's getting dark and gritty these days.
Oh yeah. Well, let's lighten the mood and invite everyone to sing along with the rousing Christmas carol.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Longhorns. It seems like we've been here for a while, and I'm starving. I could really go for some brownies.
Good news for you. Ashville and Madison made some and showed us how to make them.
What? Let's check it out.
I'm Ashma.
I'm Madison.
I'm Charlie.
And today we're making brownies!
Brownies!
This is what you need. So your first step is to preheat your oven to 350.
Pro tip, you gotta whisk out all the powder, you know what I'm saying?
Step 3, dump the water into the brownie mix. Step 4, now add 2/3 cup of vegetable oil. Step 5, crack 2 eggs into the mix.
Pro tip, also probably step number 6, whisk everything together.
Can I own it?
Yeah.
Step 7, pour your brownie mix into the pan. Step 8, open the oven and bake it for 25 minutes.
Pro tip, always use an oven mitt so you don't burn yourself. Also could be step number 9.
Enjoy!
Well, now I'm even more hungry than I was before.
We'll eat later, Bryn. We still need to race to get our goal today for Shop with the Longhorn. So teachers, get those donations in and send those runners down to the studio.
We're going to take a short break and we'll be right back. Welcome back to the Longhorn Drive Kellathon. Longhorns, let's donate some more to this wonderful cause.
The best cause. Now let's check back in with Eric and see who he's with.
Hey guys, I'm with Brooklyn, one of our sponsors with Shop With A Longhorn. And Shop With A Longhorn is such a big event at Kell. What kind of impact do you think that has on our community?
A really big impact. These kids need a lot from us, and I know some of us get a lot for Christmas, but they don't really get anything, and they're very hungry because they mostly only eat at school. So it's important for us to donate if we have something to donate.
Shop With A Longhorn, how long have you been doing it at Kell?
I've done it every year that I've been at Kell, and in eighth grade I volunteered when my sister was here.
And how did you feel whenever you did it?
I felt great. Like one year we had money, but we were about to check out at Walmart, and then I looked at the bottom of his shoes because he was sitting on a stool and he had holes in his shoes. So I was like, we don't have any money left. So then I just bought them. Because then like, he shouldn't be going around walking like his feet touching the ground, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Like I remember one year, it was like my eighth grade year, this kid wanted a Christmas tree because he never had a Christmas tree. So I cried. And it was really sad. But then he got a Christmas tree, but it wasn't like with his money, like we just bought him a Christmas tree.
That's good. Happy ending. So
yeah, it's great.
What else do we need to make this Shop With Longhorn happen?
Need to freaking donate, okay? I'm sorry, but so far we have $250 and that's unacceptable.
Yeah, we need a whole lot more moolah. And Fruity Pebbles, because they're really good.
Okay. We have 268, sorry. But still, the goal's 3,000. What is wrong with y'all? Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. You just got to get these people into the giving spirit. Mm-hmm. Shop With A Longhorn. Shop With A Longhorn is such a great thing. Well, it was great talking to you and everything. So, Shop With A Longhorn, make sure you donate. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thanks, Eric. Now all this holiday stuff is making me forget about what's coming up next week.
Black Friday?
No, Thanksgiving. Here's an informative video about the actual first Thanksgiving.
I'm king of the werewolves, and we're about to go to war with the king of the chickens and turkeys.
I am Artorias, king of the chickens and turkeys. And today, you shall win the war against the werewolves.
King Artorias, king of the chickens and turkeys, I challenge you to war in this future. If I win, we eat your people. And if you win, we leave. You accept this war.
Challenge accepted.
All right. My people will not be outdone by chickens.
Is that a challenge?
Yes. Before the werewolves.
Never! The turkeys must continue to live. They must not be eaten. The turkeys must live.
They will not live any longer. Just accept defeat, so
never.
This is a win for the werewolves. Thank you for giving us these lovely people to eat.
Wow, I learned a lot from that.
Yep. Let's check in with what's going on out there around campus. What was your favorite Christmas present as a child?
I had a for real friend, like a big horse thing.
What was yours?
I got a 3DS when I was a child, and I played that every day.
I had one.
What was your favorite Christmas present as a child?
I got a trampoline when I was like 10, and that was really cool.
Did you shoot out the trampoline?
No, we actually sold it.
How did you learn the truth about Santa Claus?
My mom told me that. Don't put that in there. What's your favorite Christmas song?
Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree.
Do you believe in Santa?
Yes.
Oh. The camera, just depending on where you want to go in the studio.
Great job, Longhorns. We've reached $299 out of our $2,500 goal. Just keep on donating and we'll reach it.
Bryn?
Yeah, Mia?
Can I ask you a question?
Okay.
What's Santa Claus's real name?
I don't know.
Kris Kringle. Man, there's a lot that you don't know. Maybe this informative Q&A video will help you out.
I hope so.
Hey guys, I'm with
Mr. Honeycutt,
and I'm going to ask him a few questions about Christmas. So, do you believe in Santa Claus?
Yes, I do. There was one year when I had little kids, my wife would not let me get an Xbox. And on Christmas Day, underneath the tree, there was an Xbox, and it had to be Santa. And boy, was my wife surprised.
Okay, so what is a Christmas song that makes you cringe?
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, because then I had to watch the TV show or the movie. I didn't really like the movie, so now when I ever hear the song, I think of a movie I didn't really like.
Thank you.
So I'm here with
Coach Smith.
And would you rather have no winter break or no spring break?
No winter break. Gotta keep the sun out.
I agree. I like that answer.
Hi, I'm Steven.
Hey, I'm Colin Foles.
And Colin. When do you start putting up your Christmas decorations?
I say around December 1st or like around the first week of December. So like around like December 1st or December 5th. That keeps line up.
Seems like a good time. Do you put up a real or fake Christmas tree?
It depends. Usually, as a family, we put up a fake, but some Christmas we put up real, but this year we're putting up fake.
Fake.
Fake's where that. Fake's where
that. Hi, I'm here with
Coach Burris.
Coach Adams.
And what kind of holiday shoppers are you guys? Black Friday, Christmas Eve, or year longers?
Definitely, unfortunately, a Christmas Eve shopper. Last minute.
Rough, rough.
I'm more of like from Thanksgiving to Christmas, doing like a little bit ahead of time.
More organized, spread out. And also, can you guys use one noise to describe how excited you are for Christmas?
Ooh.
Yay! Exciting. Thank you, guys. I'm here with
Good Grandma.
So, I have a question for you. Use one noise to describe how excited you are for Christmas.
Yee! I love Christmas, man. It's like my favorite.
So, I'm with
Mikey Bates.
And I'm asking him, if you were trapped in a Christmas movie, which would you choose?
I would go in the Grinch because I want to, like, tackle the Grinch and kidnap him before he steals all the kids' toys.
Sounds like a good idea. So I'm with Miss Lopez, and I'm going to be asking her, what kind of holiday shopper are you? A Black Friday, Christmas Eve, or year-long hoarder?
Definitely a Black Friday.
Why?
Because it gets in my blood boils, and it just makes me excited. So Black Friday.
Me too.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays. Bye.
Wow, I learned a lot from that.
Well, it's about time for Brendan and I to say goodbye, but there's still plenty of time for everyone to donate. We're going to take a short break, and Santi and Hayden will be taking over our hosting duties.
Thank you, Longhorns, for all you've already donated, but just know there's still plenty of time. Let's all join together in another sing-along.
Thank you.
Thank you, Marshall. Welcome back, Longhorns. I'm Santa Clause.
And I'm Hayden the Elf, and we're back to help raise more money for Shop With A Longhorn.
We've got a lot more videos and interviews for you to see, but first let's check out what we've raised so far.
As of 11/17, we've raised about $298, which is still pretty far from our goal, so don't forget to keep donating, guys.
Great job, Longhorns. Hayden, I have a problem, though.
Oh, Santi, what is it?
I've been invited to like 10 ugly sweater parties, but I only have a few. I can't wear the same ugly sweater to 10 different parties. It'd be a disaster.
But Santi, don't you remember me and you went sweater shopping the other day?
We did?
Yeah, we vlogged about it.
Oh, I guess we did vlog. I forget about everything. Let's check out that vlog.
Oh, This is wrong
one way.
Side.
It's one way.
You're going the wrong way.
Okay. This is why this is illegal.
Just kill us with one of you. Anyway. I'm satisfied because I have
so we're here at Walmart. We're about to find some ugly Christmas sweaters.
Kellathon.
Yeah.
Donate, Shop With A
Longhorn. Oh yeah, do
that. Sati just got
we rode together.
Sati just got an amazing parking spot.
Congrats.
Here at Walmart.
Great. We're ready. Let's go get these.
For walking into Walmart.
We're gonna buy some ugly Christmas sweaters. Purple vlog.
People are gonna look at us and be like, oh, he shaved his head for last week.
That's so cool.
Just a nice little montage. Should I get that peppermint purse? Replace it with one that works.
Fine.
Light up sweaters if you want to pull it. What's going
on? There's a ugly Christmas onesie.
Light a machine.
That's a Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer one. Or just Rudolph. It's just a snow bunny. Ooh, those are cool. Honestly, oh, are we near the art supplies?
How much is it? Oh, sealer.
Put your drink in my pouch. Put your drink in my pouch.
I was like, put my Dunkin' in here.
Oh yeah, this is exactly what grandma would wear. Very nice wolf.
My grandma
would wear. Dude, men's. This one's kind of cool. You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer
and Vixen. Comet and Cupid and Donner. I have to cop.
But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose.
And if oh, wait, you ever saw it, you would even say
all of the other ladies'
favorite.
Santa's used to laugh and call
him names. That's us, look. They never you're Santa. Joining in the reindeer. Wait, let's get a it's Navidad. For any Feliz Navidaddies. That's really nice. I like that. But what about this? It's got some little... Okay, now we're gonna go to the dressing rooms and we're gonna try on our sweaters that we picked out. This one. Actually, no, I'm not gonna show you the sweater yet.
Yeah, we can show you.
So we'll reveal the sweaters.
We'll reveal it on the show.
On the show. But we will actually try these on and show you. But you're not gonna. We're not gonna. We're not gonna tell you if we bought them or not. Now I know what YouTubers feel on an everyday basis, y'all. Okay. Honestly, it looked pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. It's pretty fresh. Here, let me get a video. I gotta do a lot to twirl around.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows.
Okay. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. Yes.
Alright, guys.
Joining any reindeer
game. That way.
That was horribly bad.
your sweater and we're done. Yeah.
Oh, that totally makes sense. I remember now.
Yeah, Santi, come on now.
Well, Hayden, let me ask you something. Do you know all of the reindeers?
Not really.
Well, let's see what the Kell students know about the holidays.
Hey guys, Hayden here. Today we're gonna be asking some students around Kell High School some Christmas trivia questions. So let's see how well people know their holiday.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the
year. I'm here with
Bo,
Sam,
Cameraman,
Jamari,
I'm Elliot,
Bryn,
Eli,
Kylie,
Mr. West.
Can y'all name all of Santa's reindeer?
You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, but do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Rudolph, Dasher. That's all I know.
Yeah, I just know Rudolph.
You would even say
Rudolph. That's about it.
Used to laugh and call him names.
Don't know that.
I can't. There's Rudolph, Prancer, Dancer, and that's about it.
Most people.
Rudolph, Vixen,
Blitzen, Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Donner, Blitzen.
I don't know. Rudolph. Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen? I don't know.
I think that's all of them.
Dancer, Prancer, Blitzen, Vixen, Rudolph, Comet, Cupid, Donner.
One more.
Oh, there's one more. There's nine with Rudolph. Jeremiah.
Jeremiah, okay. What made Frosty the Snowman come to life?
The kids that loved him.
A carrot in his nose, something like that.
Hat. His hat.
His hat.
According to the song 12 Days of Christmas, how many ladies were dancing?
Seven?
No.
Four.
No, it was nine.
Bro, I don't know.
Six?
I don't even know.
Four.
Who is Saint Nicholas?
Say hello to friends you know. And
everyone.
Nicholas is? Santa Claus?
Saint Nicholas is the patron saint of presents. And Santa Claus.
I was like, in
fact, when I was little, I thought Santa's name was Jerry.
Conclusion that not a lot of Kell students know their Christmas holiday. So y'all need to do some more research or something. Learn some more facts about Christmas. You feel me? Because not a lot of y'all know what you're talking about.
Very informative. Now I know all my reindeers. But let's remember why we're here today. Let's make sure we are donating to Shop With A Longhorn. This year's goal is $20,000, and every little bit can help.
So let's all give what we can to those in need this holiday season. And teachers, remember to send a student down with your donation slip to the audio and video studio so we can continue to update everyone on the progress on this fundraiser drive.
You know what, Hayden?
What?
Everyone talks about how they celebrate Christmas around the world, but nobody talks about how they celebrate it in the country.
What do you mean?
America has several different regions, and nobody talks about how different parts are celebrated.
Like what?
Places like Louisiana, you know, Cajun country.
Can't say I know very much about the Cajun country.
Well, luckily, Liam and Jacob made a video all about Cajun Christmas tradition. Roll it, guys.
This is a retelling of the traditional Christmas poem, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas," set in South Louisiana. This is "The Cajun Night Before Christmas" by Troclair, illustrated by James Rice. "'Twas the night before Christmas, and all true to house, they don't a thing pass, not even a mouse. The children been nestled good snug on the floe, and mama passed the paper through the crack in the dough. Then and mama in the fireplace done roast up the ham, stir up the gumbo, and make bake the yam. Then out on the bayou they got such a clatter, make sound like old Boudreaux done fall off the ladder. I run like a rabbit to get to the dough, trip over the dog, and fall on the floe. As I look out the door in the light of the moon, I think, mine, you gone crazy or got old too soon. 'Cause there on the bayou, when I stretch my neck stiff, I see 8 alligator a-pulling a skiff, and a little fat drover with a long poling stick. I know right away, got to be old St. Nick. Mo' faster and faster them gator they came, and he whistle and holler and call him by name. I got Stomp, ah, T-Boy, ah, Pierre and Alce, G. Nanette, G. Suzette, Celeste and Renee. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, make crawl, alligator, and be sure you don't fall. Like Tantaflo's cat through the treetop he fly, when that big old hound dog come a run himself by. Like that up the porch, them old gator climb, with a skiff full of toys and St. Nicholas behind. Then on the porch roof, it sound like the hail when all them big gator done sat down they tail. Then down the chimney, I yell with a bam, and St. Nicholas fall and sit on the yam. Sacre, he exclaimed, my pant got a hole. I done sat myself on them red hot coal. He got on his foots and jumped like a cat out to the floor where he land with a splat. He was dressed in muskrat from his head to his foot, and his clothes is all dirty with ashes and soot. A sack full of plaything he trail on his back. He looked like a burglar, and that's for a fact. His eyes, how they shine. His dimple, how merry. Maybe he been drink the wine from blackberry. His cheek was like rose, his nose like a cherry. On second thought, maybe he lap up the sherry. With snow-white chin whiskers and quivering belly, he shook when he laughed like the strawberry jelly. But a wink in his eye and a shook of his head make my confidence that I don't got to be scared. He don't do no talking, gone straight to his work, put plaything in sock and then turn with a jerk. He put both his hands there on top of his head, cast a eye on the chimney, and then he done said, with all of that fire and them burning hot flame, me, I ain't going back by the way that I came. So he run out the door and he climbed to the roof. He ain't no fool him for to make one more goof. He jump in his skiff and crack his big whip. Them gator move down and they don't make one slip. And I hear him shout loud as a splashing he go. Merry Christmas to all, till I saw you some mo'.
Wow, how interesting.
Really something else, right? Let's check with the student body here.
Okay, Coach Morley, so do you like Thanksgiving or Christmas better?
My wife would kill me if I didn't say Christmas.
Why is that?
It's her favorite holiday, and I also proposed to her on Christmas.
Oh, that's so cute. That's pretty cool.
Oh, thank you.
Anything else you do on Christmas? Family?
Me and all my buddies from my hometown, we get together, and like we meet and and have our own like second like Christmas dinner with each other. Friends and family kind of get a little cohesive over time, you know?
Thank you. That's pretty cool. Yeah.
But they're funny. What?
Okay, I'm here with 2/3 of the Superstar Squad and Sir Twan. It's Shop With Longhorn season, so have you ever done Shop With Longhorn before?
I have not.
Are you going to this year?
I am going to this year.
This is fantastic. What are you excited for?
I'm just excited to see, you know, like the happiness that the kids are going to get from being able to get stuff that they've never been able to get before.
That's pretty cool. How about you, Eli?
Yeah, I think being able to be with the children is just really great because a lot of kids don't get this opportunity. And so a lot of people being able to kind of help out and kind of put a little bit of money in, because really any money helps, can make a little kid's day. So,
how about you, Twan? Have you done Shop With Longhorn before?
I have.
How many times?
Only once.
Doing it this year?
You bet.
Are you excited?
Extremely.
Why?
Just seeing the kids' smiles as you're like giving them like the best day of their lives is just, it's a different type of feeling. It hits different.
It's pretty cool. Thank you.
Interviewers can get interviews. So are you doing Shop With Longhorn?
I am doing Shop With Longhorn. Are you doing Shop With Longhorn?
I am doing Shop With Longhorn. Have you ever done Shop With Longhorn before?
I have done Shop With Longhorn before.
Hey! Have you done Shop With Longhorn before?
Yes, I have.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I do.
What's your favorite part about Shop With Longhorn?
Helping the little children, I guess.
How many years have you done it?
Just last year.
Oh, okay. What is your favorite part about Christmas?
Spending time with my family.
My goodness, that's so sweet. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
I'm here with the last third of the Superstar Squad. Have you ever done Shop With Longhorn before?
No.
Are you excited? Oh, wait. Are you doing this year?
Yeah, maybe if I find a team.
Well, you should definitely find a team. Are you excited to do Shop With Longhorn? Because I know you're going
to
do it.
I am so excited to help poor kids.
Were you once that little kid?
Still am.
And as one of those little kids, how is life affected by the fact that you don't get to that... That you don't get to participate in Shop With Longhorn?
I'm sad about it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I feel that.
Uh-huh.
You should have a great day. I understand you have some paparazzi, so you can get back to whatever you're doing.
Okay. Thank
you. Yeah. Give me my hat.
Thank you.
Have you ever done Shop With Longhorn before?
Yes.
Are you going to do it this year?
Yes.
Are you excited?
Yes.
How excited? Are you excited to do Shop With Longhorn?
I can't do it this year.
Why? Because of basketball. Is basketball more important than helping little children have a Christmas?
The kid was bad, so.
Oh, did you enjoy it, though?
Yeah, I did.
What were your thoughts on the food that you ate here?
The food? It was not that good.
What tips do you have to improve the cuisine for this year?
Make the food a lot better. And be a little bit more organized.
I think that's a good tip, too. How about you? Did you do Shop With Longhorn last year?
Yeah, I did.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Was your little kid cool?
Yeah, she was cool.
Did you like the food? Oh, guys, we gotta go. Hi, Ms. Jenkins, how are you?
I'm fantastic.
Are you excited for Shop With Longhorn?
I am very excited for Shop With Longhorn.
How excited?
So excited. I'm a math teacher. Words just can't describe how excited I am.
I'm also so excited. Yeah. So why do you think Shop With Longhorn is important, and how do you think it's going to affect these little kids?
It'll affect their whole life, probably. They're going to always remember this day. And for you, you're always going to remember this day. You're going to get more out of it than probably the little kids will.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Have a good day, Ms. Jenkins.
That's just weird.
Yo, are you doing Shop With Longhorn?
I don't know yet.
You should do it.
And just so you know, we're at about $439.85, so keep donating. We just need each teacher to pass that hat and collect whatever students can get. No gift is too small. Seriously, pennies, nickels, dimes, and of course quarters and paper money. We know you guys have secret stashes for all your vending machine runs, so dig deep and give what you can. Then send a runner with a pass, of course. with the amount collected to the audio and video room 1404 near the cafeteria. Do not bring the actual money to the audio and video studio. We will collect it later today.
Once we get your class's pledge, we'll read them on the air. Think of it as a competition. In fact, it is a competition. So let's see that competitiveness between lots of classes.
Hey, do you know who we haven't heard from in a while?
Who?
Marshall, our one-man house band.
I think I'm still recovering from that last one.
Well, let's just see what he has for us.
Oh, man. You know what? That was actually pretty good. Thanks, Marshall. All right, the latest we've raised is $502.37 of our goal of $2,500. Come on, Longhorns, we're nearly at the end and I know we can raise it.
But while we wait, let's introduce Kyle, the amazing juggler.
I'm gonna have to show you how you do this, Kyle. Come on. You do four, traditionally. Now you try.
Ooh, Okay, well, while we clean up that mess, let's get the school together for another rousing of Christmas Carol.
Ho, ho, ho.
Feliz Navidad.
Y'all meet my reindeer. Oh, shoot.
Santi, what's your favorite? Okay.
We'll be right back.
Okay, Santi. Hey guys, I know y'all like Christmas music, so let's check out this carpool karaoke video.
La 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 la.
So this is, we bought these for our hair. I think they're kind of cute.
I think they're very cute. Not just kind of cute, very cute.
Okay, that's... Hey guys, what's up? We're gonna be doing a car karaoke for you today, and I hope you guys like it or whatever.
Period.
Period. Jingle bells, jingle bells ring, jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing the bushes of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven.
Fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Finest gifts we bring, ba-ra-ba-bum-bum. To lay before the king, ba-ra-ba-bum-bum, ba-ra-ba-bum-bum, ba-ra-ba-bum-bum.
Yeah, check it, check it.
Surprised you didn't hear this in the Bible. I'm so tight, I might go psycho. Christmas time, so here's a recital. I'm so bad, I might go. I know I'm still young, but I go stupid, stupid. Love like Cupid. I'm a trouble boy, so do. It's the best time of the year. Now, I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone.
Hey Johnny!
Oh, the mistletoe is hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you. Kiss her once for me. Now of the mistletoe is hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you. Kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas. Oh, by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas.
Old Jimmy.
Someday at Christmas, then won't be yours.
Then with bombs,
like kids play with toys. Then one December, our house will shake. The world where men are free. Someday all our dreams will come to be. Someday in a world where men are free. Maybe not in time for you and me.
Never bump old Justin Bieber again.
Santa, tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if you won't be here next year.
Time to focus when I see him walking across the room. And his team was passing out. And I won't be here. I really can't stand.
It's cold outside.
I got to go
in. It's cold outside.
This evening has been.
Maybe
so
what do you have?
Longhorns, there's still plenty of time to donate to Shop With A Longhorn. Our program is ending soon. Our count right now is $608.65.
But we'll continue to keep you updated on the results throughout the day through our social media pages. And make sure to tune in to Morning Moves tomorrow morning to see what our final amount was at. And thanks to all those who donated.
It is truly a great thing to give to those who do not have it, especially at this time of the year. So thank you all. Thank you for everybody who has donated and Shop With A Longhorn and all of those who benefit from it in your hearts. Sorry.
For the Kell Audio and Video Department, I'm Hayden Montross.
I'm Santi Claus. Happy holidays, and go ahead and play us out, Marshall.